Good morning. I'm Frank Reynolds. And these are the men who will make this historic voyage to the moon, the crew of Apollo 8. They are in their command module right now. They've been in there since 5:34 this morning at Cape Kennedy when the hatch was closed. The weather at the Cape is perfect, and astronauts Borman, Lovell, and Anders are all set to go. The weather at the Cape, which had caused some concern last night and yesterday, possibly it might interfere with today's launch, has cleared up, and everything is now apparently all set to go. Standing by at Cape Kennedy to bring us a late status report is ABC science editor Jules Bergman. Jules?
What we're going to see happen after a liftoff may seem to take place slowly. It takes around 2.5 minutes for those five F1 engines on the main stage to burn out. We should see that clearly. We predict there's nothing more than a little bit of scattered light cirrus clouds over the Cape and out over the Atlantic. We think our long-range cameras will see the separation and staging. Now, late word from launch control.
Follow Saturn launch control, T-minus 7 minutes, 30 seconds and counting, still aiming toward our planned liftoff time. Spacecraft test conductor Dick Prophet has just completed a status check of all elements concerned with the spacecraft operations. All reported go, and there were three particularly strong and loud goes from the three astronauts in the spacecraft 320 feet above the base of the launcher at Complex 39. Jim Lovell reported just a few minutes ago that he could see a blue sky and it looked like the sun's out. The spacecraft test conductor reported back that it's a very fine day. We're at T-minus 6 minutes, 50 seconds and counting, and we are proceeding at this time. This is launch control.
And so, some 6 minutes away from liftoff to continue the process of what will happen at liftoff, those main stage engines we've showed earlier, the five F1 main stage engines, will burn for about 2.5 minutes. When they burn out, the Saturn V will be hundreds of miles downrange from the Cape and at about 60 miles altitude over the Atlantic Ocean. Then the five smaller engines, the J2 hydrogen engines in the second stage, take over, and they'll burn until 8 minutes and 40 seconds after liftoff, propelling Apollo 8 almost, but not quite, into orbit. At that point, if anything went wrong, Apollo 8 would land somewhere east of Africa, out over the Indian Ocean. The final engine then takes over, the third stage J2 engine, which indeed puts them into a 115-mile, statute mile, circular orbit around the world. And if that engine has done its job well, they'll fly in that orbit for some 2 hours and 46 minutes until they come up over Australia on the second revolution and thence begin the historic translunar burn to escape the Earth's gravity and head toward the moon. Now let's go back to launch control for late word from NASA's Jack King. Launch control.
This is Apollo Saturn launch control at 5 minutes, 30 seconds, and our count is still go at this time. We've just completed further status checks here in the firing room at the control center. Here in the control center, we've had our status checks, and the range has given a go, as has the launch director, Rocco Patrone. We are still counting, and we are go coming up on the five-minute mark in the count. Mark, T-minus 5 minutes and counting, T-minus 5. At this point, the Apollo access arm should be coming back, and it is now moving back at the 320-foot level to its fully retracted position high atop the tower at Pad A. Our countdown is still proceeding at this time at the four-minute mark in the countdown. The overall count will be turned over to the launch vehicle test conductor. Ray Roberts, the launch vehicle test conductor, will conduct the final 4 minutes as all different aspects move over to the launch vehicle test conductor's channel. The automatic sequence, as reported, will come in at the 3 minute and 6 second mark in the countdown. We're standing by at 4 minutes, 16 seconds and counting. This is launch control.
And if we were in launch control at this moment, we would hear a mysterious chant going. A chant of voices that would say, go and launch, commit, as they go up and down the consoles there in launch control, checking out every stage of the booster, every one of hundreds of key electrical systems, onboard computers, and items on the spacecraft. And the word is commit. And launch is now being handled, as it has been for the last 2 minutes, automatically by computers from T-minus 6 minutes on downward. No man's hand touches what goes on except to stop the process in case something goes wrong. It's an automated launch. It has to be. Let's hear late word from launch control now.
Mark, T-minus 3 minutes and 30 seconds and counting. We have completed our communications checks with the Apollo 8 astronauts in the cabin, and the communications are go. Coming up shortly, we'll be in the automatic sequence where we have a completely automatic checkout of the launch vehicle from 3 minutes and 6 seconds down. We have firing command. The firing command is in. We are now on the automatic sequence, T-minus 3 minutes and counting. During this period, once we do get the firing command, the various tanks within the three stages of the Saturn V launch vehicle begin to pressurize. They all must be under pressure before we're ready to launch. We have a sequence status board here in the control room that will give us readouts on the overall status of the space vehicle as we reach the terminal phases in the countdown. Now, two minutes, 32 seconds, and counting. Our status board indicates that all aspects are ready. Instrument unit is ready. Spacecraft ready. Final check of the emergency detection system. That ready light also on. First stage preparations are completed. 2 minutes, 15 seconds and counting. The tanks continuing to pressurize in the vehicle. Not as many reports coming now as we all stand by on the launch vehicle test conductor's channel. Coming up on the 2 minute mark on the Apollo 8 mission. 2 minutes and counting. T minus 2 minutes and counting. We are still proceeding. We now have recorded that the first stage liquid oxygen tank has been pressurized and the pressure is still building up. 1 minute, 45 seconds and counting. We have a vehicle weighing 6.2 million pounds on the pad. Interestingly enough, some 1,200 pounds of that weight is just frost on the side of the vehicle created by the extremely low temperatures of the propellants. Coming up on 90 seconds, mark, T-minus 90 seconds and counting. The Apollo 8 crew standing by, spacecraft commander Frank Borman, Jim Lovell, Bill Anders. We now have a report that the liquid hydrogen tank on the third stage is pressurized. 1 minute, 15 seconds. All third stage propellants pressurized at this time as we come up on the 60-second mark on a flight to the moon.
there's that majestic plume of flame behind the Saturn V as she thunders into the sky, gathering speed.
At this point, the crew has been given a go for staging.
She's now more than 30 miles high, 4,300 miles an hour speed.
Frank Borman says the inboard engines, 2 minutes, 25 seconds.
There it is, staging and the burnout of the first stage engines, right on the money.
See the first stage cut off. S2 has ignited, we can confirm. And the thrust looks good. All engines, all sources show the second stage is burning perfectly. 2 minutes, 51 seconds into the mission.
6,000 miles an hour, more than 225,000 feet high, burning beautifully. Borman, Lovell, and Anders off perfectly.
Then released at the key. 3 minutes into the flight, we're 50 miles high.
There's the escape tower separating.
And about 10 miles downrange. We have verified that the tower has jettisoned. The crew has verified the tower has jettisoned.
Every event taking place exactly as scheduled.
Frank Borman says staging was smooth, and he says the ride now is even smoother.
I guess you're about the only person around that doesn't have TV coverage of the scene.
That's all right, I don't mind a bit.
They've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the limit.
Are you getting a TV picture now, Houston?
Neil, yes, we are getting a TV picture. You're in our field with you now.
That's one small step for man. One giant leap for mankind.